Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over very quickly how you could set up a quick text feedback user interface and also a quick image that could pop up. So we're going to use this example map and we'll have some text feedback and the map will show up in the screen. So let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a folder for my user interface element. So I'll just call that UI, hit enter. We'll double click on that, right click, and create a user interface widget. So there's the widget blueprint. We'll call this my UI. So we'll double click to open that. And here's the user interface, or UMG, Unreal Motion Graphics editor. We've got a bunch of different palettes and different interface elements we can add. For this example, I'm just going to add a text object here. This text box is for input. This is just mostly, we're going to give feedback to the user. And so we'll drag one of those. And we're also going to do an image. Let's first take a look at the text box a little bit. So I'm mouse scrolling in a little bit. We're going to make the text appearance just a little bit bigger. We'll say like 36. And we could change the font, we could change how the justification is, we're going to center it. How does it also, this is how it's centered relative to the user interface. So I'm going to make that centered and pretty much it's like very centered on the user interface. So then we'll make the picture also similarly centered, and we'll also make the X and Y size 256 by 256 since the map image is square. So we've got that set up. Let's drag the map image in. So I've already created a really quick texture and I'm just going to drag that in here. Okay, so we can see that's already set up pretty well. So now what we need to do is bind that. Bind these so that we can talk to them from the level blueprint. So I'm going to first bind the text block and we'll go in and go find where the text is. Go and create a binding. And then in order to for us to talk to this, we need a variable that we need to talk to. So I'm dragging off of this little node here and I'm going to promote to a variable. We'll call this my UI text. Just nudge that down. Save that. We'll go back to the designer and we'll do the same thing with the map. So we could swap in different map images as we found them or pieces of a map. We could do something complicated. For this example, I'm just going to modify or control the visibility. So instead of binding the brush, which would be the image, I'm going to go down and look for visibility and we'll bind the visibility. So we'll drag off that and we'll promote that to a variable and we'll say my map visibility. Great. Nudge that down just a little bit so we can see it a little better. Use the arrow keys. All right, great. So the other thing that we want to look for too is, do we want this visible? Like, what's the default? So we're going to say the default is hidden, and that's kind of important. Otherwise, it'll just show up in the screen when we launch the user interface. All right, so we've got that set up now. Let's just get the user interface. We have to set it up in the level blueprint. Well, we don't have to set up in the level blueprint, but we are going to set it up in the level blueprint for this example. So we'll say on level begin, just add event on begin play. What are we going to do? We are going to create a widget. And what is the widget we're going to create? Well, we're going to create a widget based off of the My User interface. And in order to talk to all the values inside that widget, I'm promoting this to a variable. So now we'll call this my great UI variable. And so now with this great UI variable that I've just created within the level blueprint, I can call variables that I've created inside the UMG. So let's do the final step, which is this. We need to put this on the screen. And to do that, we just add it to the viewport. Great. Okay, so now we should be all set with that. Now, what I'm going to do is set it up so that I've created a trigger volume and just a representation of this map really quickly. And I'm going to say when we step into that trigger volume, we'll just pretend like we've picked up the map, and we'll give a feedback to text feedback and visual feedback on our user interface. So when we we'll say on the event, let's see if I've got the trigger volume selected. When we walk into the trigger volume, we'll say we're going to call something from our great UI variable. What are we going to call? We're going to call some of those variables. So the visibility. So we're going to set the map visibility. We'll set that to visible. So that's the easy. And then what else are we going to do? We're going to set text, the UI text, to something. Say, we could create a separate text variable and pipe that in, or even an array, and then do different text feedbacks. For this example, I'm just going to keep it simple and just type right in here and say something like, "You found the map." Great. And then just to make this seem like we pick up the map, I'm going to select this map. Could make it movable if we wanted to. And I'm going to create a reference to it. And I'm going to destroy it. And we'll just hook that all up and we'll try it out. We'll compile. We're getting a little bit of an error here. So before we test, let's see what we've got some sort of. Oh, we've got two event begin plays. Let's compile again and see if we're good. All right. Excellent. Let's play. So let's look around. Where's that map? Oh, look, there's a map. Let's walk over and pick it up. And we've got a map showing up and some text. So awesome. So thanks so much for watching. Have a good night.